Today, we're going to check out the material library in Lightburn. I'm going to show you how to set it up and especially how to use it if you're a beginner. Let's go. So let's jump into using the libraries in Lightburn. So we're going to do a bit of a deep dive here, and that is the fact that we're going to use the what they is called the library or the materials library. And the library allows you to organize and store different material settings for your laser, which is great because it just means that with having all these different material settings on hand, you get to create your projects and workflow so much faster. And if you are someone who uses an emblazer, there is a set of library settings that comes with the machine. So you have probably about 12 or 14 pieces of material that you can put in. Now, all material is not made equal. I have certain themes that I would love to drum into people's heads. So, you know, one of them would be if you go and buy some plywood, if I buy it from Bunnings or I buy it from a laser specialty store, it's not going to be the same. But all these settings are great places to begin your journey. So unless you've tested the material before, use these settings, see what results you get out of them. And sometimes you have to modify them. I know that when I go to Bunnings, I can buy plywood 1 week, cut perfectly through it, and then a new shipment comes in and it's like a completely different result. But as I said, most of the times, it cuts through. These are settings that are worked out from the people at Darkly Labs. And it is just kind of an awesome thing that they hand you kind of like the keys to different materials straight away. But what happens if you don't have a material, or maybe it's not in the settings, or maybe you've worked out the settings yourself, but you write them into a book, but I want to put them into Lightburn so they're always there? Well, we're going to go through and show you all of that. Just to let you guys know that the material library is found in the bottom area, bottom right hand side. There's two tabs. One is the library tab and one is the laser tab. The laser tab is where you actually start running the job and you using things like the frame. But on the other tab, that's where the library can be found. And I will share it with you how you can create your own library settings and how you can use those library settings in your jobs. All right, so here we are. Cool, we're still here. So, you can see I've just created a box, and you can see over there you've got an acrylic setting, and usually they come with three different types of settings. One's a fill, one's an image, and one's a line. And you can assign those by clicking the assign button and then clicking up that cut layer. And if you were fast enough, you'd actually see that that layer changed, max power and speed number. So, and you can see in here when you double click it, it comes up with all the different options. So we're going to pick the image. Well, it's not going to do an image now. Let's try the fill again. There we go. And it just jumped to 1,000. And we're going to change it to a line cut now. And you can see there, it just jumped to 180. So that's a way of knowing that you've assigned it properly. Now we go down, you've got things for balsa wood. You got card, corrugated cardboard, felt. This is natural felt. Felt synthetic. Now I have foam sheet because I cut a lot of EVA, so I have foam sheet, and I have another setting for white because white reflects a lot of energy. Leather, MDF, paper. So different grades of paper are also come standard. Then there's plywood like birch, eucalypt, generic, and popular. That's all the laser stuff. And then at the end, there's another one called rubber. So in my library right now, rubber is something that you can't cut. I was using this as a test, but I was also showing you how to remove and how to create a rubber setting. Rubber, I have never tried in the laser, but it's a good way of just being sure. So right there, you can see that you just highlight them and remove them. And now we're going to actually create a setting in the library that we can save. And we just do that by clicking the create setting and the material type. Because it was rubber before, we're going to create a material type for adamantium, which actually you could never cut, if anyone knows the reference there. And the very first one we're going to do is we're going to create a line. So we put that in the description, hit the OK button, and you can see here it creates a material, and underneath there, the thickness was 1 mil, and there's our line command right there. By going back and editing the cut, it pulls up the cut settings, and we can adjust them accordingly. So in this case, I'm actually just saying that it's a line cut, and because adamantium is an unbreakable metal, speed, we're going to go down as low as possible. Now, I've done 2, but it defaults to 180, and I found that out the hard way. But because we have to do multiple passes to try and cut through, we put 28. Just want to take a moment out to invite you to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you don't miss out on any videos to do with Lightburn, lasers, and making things. We also run a live stream twice a month to invite everyone together to share what they make, tips and tricks, and the latest on what you can do with your lasers. If you're interested, you can also become a member of the community on our Facebook page, which happens to be the link right below. Anyway, let's get back to the tutorial. I want to make a fill command, but I want to make that fill command, I'm going to actually clone another fill command and then copy it into the adamantium by changing the material name and actually editing the description to fill. So when you see that, when I say okay, it actually is now a fill command, and all I've got to do is change the speed and how many times it passes. And in this, I think I did it a little bit less. Instead of 20, there you go, 28, I think I brought it down a little bit, and we just max powered it again because of the fact that we're talking about a material that we couldn't cut anyway, so we're just using it as a simulation. But I find that the fastest way to create these settings is just to actually clone them or duplicate them into the new material that you want. It's a really fast way, and that way all you've got to really concentrate on is changing the power and the speed, and if you want to actually also do the passes. So once you've worked that out, you can put that in. And you can see we're building this adamantium library right now. So we're gonna go back to Balsa. We've got a line, we've got the fill. We're gonna do the same thing with an image. So we're gonna duplicate that. All you gotta do again, as I said before, is just change the material name. So we're typing in adamantium, and under description, I am going to go and make that an image. You'll see that just popped up under adamantium, under 1 mil. Now, in this case, because we can't choose an image, this is probably the fastest way to create a new setting that works. So number of passes, you can also change the image mode. And I'm gonna grab an image in a second to make sure that I can apply it and it's got the same images. Let's close up the Balsa. Now, I go, all right. We're going to go and use that art, I believe it's the art library. We set that up last time. So even I have to go, hang on, where is that? It's in the window. Let's go to the art library. Here it is. We're going to grab this Darkly Labs Hall of Fame graphic, which is, I believe, a JPEG. And we'll scale it down once I remember to put it on select. How many people do that? How many times do you use a tool and forget, oh, damn, I should be on select? We're just gonna put it in there. Scale it down a bit. We'll highlight it and also use the align tools here just to make sure it's in the middle. Excellent. And now we're gonna go to the image. We'll hit that align in layer. And now it's at 180. So we know that those settings work in the library. And it's that easy to be able to create your own set of library presets, which means that you, if you're using a material that's not standard, you can work it out and be able to add them into your own library. Now, the wonderful thing is that now we've got the adamantium, we're gonna save that library, because if we get out of Lightburn and come back in, it's not gonna be there. So hit that save as button. Now I'm gonna change the title a bit to adamantium. And actually, the only issue that I had with this was that you can't see the name up above, just underneath the library. So I'm gonna try and load that up a few times and nothing kind of really changed. So I'm gonna save it again in a second as adamantium, and you'll actually see that the library itself, the name above where all those settings will actually change. And that's kind of really important, because if you're using multiple libraries in your workflow, you want to be able to change from a library and know which one you're working on. And if you have multiple libraries with different elements in them, they can be a little bit confusing. So I realized here, because we had such a large name, I couldn't get it to come out to display. So we saved it as Adamantium, and you'll see in a second here, we'll load that library up. And again, it's just, if you haven't set up a library, I strongly suggest creating a directory in, let's say, a documents folder, and actually using those as your library, because it is awesome to be able to open up multiple libraries. And here you go. Here's the Adamantium one. You can see it just popped up. There's the Adamantium. And there's all our settings. So you can create as many options as you would like in the library. So if you're using, let's say, some material for a job, and you're only going to use it for a job, you can make a library just for those jobs, create and expand the library in Lightburn. And this is one of the features that I love, really, really love in Lightburn. It is just such an awesome feature to have these libraries that you can instantly work out and instantly make. And you can see here, I'm actually making a brand new library. There's nothing else added. We're going to call it test. We're going to make the thickness 2 mil, and this is the line, and there you go. It's really that easy. So if you don't want to mess around with the library that you have from Darkly, or even the preset that comes with Lightburn, if you're not using it in Blazor, you can just go and make a brand new library and start playing with these features, start applying them, see how they work. Here you go again. I'm just going in there, changing settings so that when I apply them, I can see that it's working. We're going to make that a line. And you'll see here, we'll assign it, it becomes a line, and it all works. I'd love to hear about how you utilize this amazing tool in all the comments below. And until I see you next time, go and check out these videos right here and learn a little bit more about using your laser and Lightburn. Go make something amazing.